Hello friends, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to show you how to draw a running pose. In animation we use this pose very regular, and in illustration also if some situation or if any script requires, then we'll draw a running pose. But we need to see whether this pose is that much strong enough or not. So in this video I'll show you that. And how to know the pose is good enough, we'll see in this video. For that we need some practices, and some tips are there. We need to practice those things. After then we can do our own running pose. So let's get started. So first I'll tell you the stick figure, which is the basic form of any character design. To draw any pose we require some baseline, some lines that gives you an idea what the pose is. So what I'll do, I'll show you few poses of running. Like I'll draw here the head, the body, the legs, so this is a pose which we can say it's walking, not running. So what we will change that it will look like run. If I'll change this leg to this, see, it will look like running. Got my point? So running has some poses we need to keep in mind. Like if one leg is on the ground, then another will be on air. This is a good pose to show your audience or the viewer that it's on running. So yeah, but this is not that much strong pose. We need to draw strong pose, that is more important, so that the drawing will be appealing. Appealing means it will attract the viewers to see your drawing. Okay, so this is little okay, running pose means it's a normal pose. So further, if we'll go in the next step, what changes we can do with this running pose. What I'll do, this is the head. Okay, if we'll see this, if I'll draw a straight line here, you can find that this is little tilted. What I'll do, I'll tilt little more. Okay, and this is the hip, and then I'll draw the leg. Okay, so till now you have understood that we need to tilt the body, the torso. Okay, this is the torso. So now what we'll do, we'll do the leg, the next leg. Okay, fine. So suppose this is the right leg and this is the left leg, then the hand, okay, I'll draw the neck over here, and this is the shoulder. If this is left, then the hand, the left hand will be back. This is front, so the left hand will be back. And the right will be front. Got my point? So if we'll compare both the drawing, you will find that this one is more stronger than this. Okay, so if the script requires, like it is running normal, at a normal speed, then it is okay. If you want to go to next level, then you can do it like I'm doing over here. Again, we'll draw a head. Okay, this is the head. And now what I'll do, I'll tilt the body. See, this is the, like this is the, I have told you in my earlier videos that this is the center line. and this is the eye line. Okay, so suppose I am putting roughly the eyes. Okay, you'll get an idea. So here what I'll do, I'll tilt the body more and the legs, I'll draw like this. Okay, and now if you'll see here, the distance here and here is almost equal. And now what I'll do, I'll exaggerate or I'll increase the length, the distance. Okay, see. Okay, he is running out of fear. Then what will be the expression, as I have told you in my earlier videos? It will be like this. Okay. Okay, this is not the video of expression though, but I am telling you to give you a revision. So this is, it is clearly visible that this is the left leg and this is the right leg. See, so if this is the right, then here it should be front. So what I'll do, this is the right one and back side it is the left one. So in the stick figure, you need to observe and you need to see whether this is right or left. When you will put the muscles, the volume in your character, then you should not get confused which hand, which leg. So you should be very clear about this legs and hands. Okay. So now it is clearly visible that this is more stronger than this, because this is wide than this and this hands are also wide. Even more you can do, like this is the more extreme pose I am doing. So you will get an idea, like this distance between two legs is more and the distance more than these three. This is looking more strong than these three. And here if you want, you can, like this hands are, you can see this is in the line and this is not. So it will not look that much strong than this. Okay. So how to put the volume on these type of characters? What I do, I'll show you in my drawing over here. But whenever you will plan for the pose, just go for rough like this, then only you put your volume. It will be good enough, like you will get the idea how to draw and where to put the muscles and all. Okay, I'll give you some tips separately and individually so that it will be easier for you to draw this type of running pose. So whenever the hand is going back, I'm talking about this hand, okay? Suppose this is the right hand and this is the left. So right means this is the right leg, okay, and this is the left. So talking about the right one, if it is going, see, back side is the shoulder, then the hand, okay, this is the curve because it is going that side. Okay, keep in mind this is more important, this curve. If you'll draw this hand, the same thing, if I'll draw like this, see the difference, it's the same hand but the arc, the curves, if you'll do it differently, see, big difference will be there. that you will get to know when you'll draw the character with volume. Okay, so this is the right hand, and about left hand how it will be, I'll show you. You can draw foreshortening, or you can do like this. It's up to you. Sorry. So you should be clear. Sorry, again, what I did see. This hand, if you draw it like this, it will give the illusion as if this hand is going that side. So keep in mind, it should be like this. When I'll draw the character, you'll get to know the problem. What if I'll draw wrong curves, and what if I'll do the right curves? That is a more important thing. Okay, here the body. See the body. Okay, this is the right, and this is the left. Coming to the body, if the body is like this, give it a volume first. Okay, this is the base one, chest line, and this is the stomach. Okay, so here you can give like this, so all the lines will be like this only, this curve. And if here you will do like this, means what it will feel like? It will feel like it is going that side. It's totally wrong. Okay. So keep all these things in mind. The lines and the curves, where you are doing like C curve and D curve, you should keep in mind all these things. Legs is also the same. The curve will be like this only. And for this, sorry, this one. Shoes also you need to keep in mind, like if this is the right one, how you should keep. Okay. Like this. Fine. Let's do the pose with volume, so you'll get to know the mistakes. Okay. Here I'll do one character running. Thank you. So here you can see that I have completed the run pose, and what I have taught you in this, I have just kept all the things like this. Like here the legs, see, I'll give you a little explanation. As I have chosen a fat character in the running pose, here it is little difficult to make is the left leg, this one, because we don't know where the leg will lie. So for this, what I told you, that you need to draw a stick figure. If you are able to draw a stick figure, then it will be very easy for you to find out where the leg will lie. So here you can see this face is there with this round shape head, and then the body, okay, then the leg, then the another leg, the hand, and then the next hand. This is the basic form I have shown you. But here in this character, it is not that much exaggerated though, because this is a fat character. You can make some SFX, special effects. Okay, that I'll tell you how to draw the special effects and all in some other videos. Okay. So now this is not the extreme pose. I should not say this is the extreme pose, but this is a good pose, like this one, the third one. Okay. See, if you want to do more exaggerated, then if you'll take a thin character, though this also will work. But what I was trying to say is, at the beginning stage only, I'll take the line like this. And I'll put on head. This will be a little rough, as I need to complete the video within a stipulated time. So this will be rough, it will be not that much clear, okay? So this is another character. This is little extreme pose. So you can make some variations, and you can do more exaggerated run pose. So try to do some stuff like this and play with this type of poses, so that you will get the knowledge about the running pose. Watch more cartoons, and you can take the Asterix book. There the poses of the running are very nice, and Asterix I used to follow. You can find out in Google Asterix, A-S-T-E-R-I-X, I think. You just find it out. And yeah, this type of drawing will improve your skills of making running poses. So yeah, that's it for now. I have done two poses of this running, which is like this. And you can see this, I have told you, this and this. This one is this and this one is this. So try to make a run pose more. And this one is in 3/4 pose. I'll show you more in front and the profile, that means the side one. Yeah, that's it for now. And if you like this video, then hit a thumbs up, share with your friends. If you are coming here for the first time, then subscribe it and hit the bell icon beside the subscribe button, so that you will get the notification whenever I will upload any new videos. You will get the notification, so don't forget to hit the bell button as well. Stay tuned for my next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.